basswood for the bottom because it carves good, and mahogany for the top size because it's going to be finished bright.
What do you have in the middle there for the boot
That's
top?
That's mahogany. There's
mahogany,
no boot
top. Just a darker color.
Now, the messy part is gluing.
Regular wood glue.
You gotta stop it for a second. I gotta get a foam brush.
I don't see one that I can reach.
I gotta stop for a minute.
Just go ahead and get it. I'm gonna let the thing run. How long have you been making the half models, Dad?
How long?
Yeah, when did you start?
Early 70s.
And you taught yourself how to do it?
Yep.
What was the purpose of the half hoddles back when your grandfather and great-grandfather were making wooden boats?
They carved a half model to see if they liked the shape of it because they didn't have any plans.
And then they'd show the customer the half model and
get
a commission based on that?
Yeah.
I feel bad, like I should be spreading it out for you. So you get it on really thick because you don't care how much oozes out. You just want it to be completely bonded, right?
Yep.
So you just put a shitload on. More glue is better. But don't get it on the handle of your brush. What kind of boat is this one going to be? I didn't even think to ask.
A cat boat that's at the Oslo Museum called Francis.
Ah, Francis. And what year was Francis built again?
1968.
And when was the first cat boat built?
Around 1850.
The first catboat was built by your grand... Was it your great-great-grandfather?
Horace S. Crosby finished it with his brother and his father, Andrew. I think it was Andrew started it.
So Horace S. was your great-grandfather. My great-great-grandfather, right?
No, great. All right, I always nail these pieces together a little bit because when you glue them...
Hold on, I got it.
When you glue them, they slide.
Okay.
And I always... It's easier to pre-drill the holes with the nails.
Okay, yeah. See, those holes are pre-drilled. So Horace S. Crosby finished building the first capo with his brother C. Worthington after their father Andrew died. Yep. And in order to finish it, their mother, Terza Lovell Crosby, hired a medium from off Cape named Mrs. Manley to come and tip tables and have a seance to figure out how to finish the boat. And that's why all the Crosby men in every generation after that have the name Manley as their first or middle names. Malcolm is Malcolm Manley.
When I'm clamping this, the start, I reverse the clamps.
So the pressure is even?
So there's a less chance of it sliding.
Okay.
I hope. I always cut the wood longer, wider, and a little thicker than I need it, because I...
And use wax paper so you don't make too much of a mess on your bench.
Yeah, wax paper or plastic.
You need a lot of clamps. How many do they want to have? To start, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I may put more on.
7, 8. C clamps. How come you're not alternating these?
What do you mean?
I thought you were going to alternate the direction they were
clamping. No, because I have to be able to tip this to clean the glue off.
Oh, okay, okay.
It's just a start. And I'm going to put another piece of plastic down too, wax paper.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
These little pieces of wood that you glued and tacked down to the mahogany are just to keep the cement from making the indents in the wood.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You have little pieces of mahogany tacked into the...
That's because I need a little bit of wood at the seam, because it's a...
Oh, okay. Oh, you got drips. I gotta help you.
I don't care about that.
What's going on your bench and your sea clams? And your measurements.
I'll get it.
All right, so you've got your new piece of wax paper down, wiping up your major drips. And for the next video, the next step, how many steps of carving do you usually have? What do you start with to carve it?
I just do this so the air can get underneath it.
Yeah.
I have to flatten the backside perfect, clean up the top, put the templates on, and cut it out on the bandsaw. These are the two templates.
Okay.
I have stations, a whole bunch of stations for the shape of the hull.
Cool. So that'll be in the next video, flattening one side perfectly and starting the carving. Thanks.